Let's talk about DALL-E 3 and how it's going to change the game when it comes to image generators. I'm super excited about this and I wanted to talk about why in this video. But let's just quickly talk about the main reason why this is so exciting. If you actually go onto their OpenAI's terms and conditions, okay, and click on terms of use and then control F and then commercial, you'll see right here that it says input and output are collectively content as between the parties and to the extent permitted by applicable law, you own all input. So if you own the input, then you also, subject to your compliance with these terms, OpenAI hereby assigns to you all its right, title, and interest in and to output. This means you can use content for any purpose, including commercial purposes such as sale or publication, if you comply with these terms. And basically what that means is as long as you're not making like a McDonald's logo stamped on a cat or you're not using something copyright, you are going to be able to actually sell these images. The reason I mention this is because there's been a lot of hype about Ideogram, and obviously I was originally going to make a video about this because, you know, I do talk about print on demand, etc. But if you actually go on their terms of use, you'll see that at least at the moment, you cannot sell for money, okay? But it may be illegal to use them without permission due to copyright infringement. Let's go on their actual terms of service. This could be their website terms of service, so it might be a bit pointless looking at. But basically, Ideogram does not let you use the images to sell, so you can't use them for print on demand. Now, let's talk a little bit about why this is going to be such a huge difference. Now, if we take this prompt here, this is the prompt right here. And we copy this prompt, and we're going to use this on Midjourney as well. Just so you can see why this is such a big step up. So first of all, we have an avocado with it's basically been cut in half and the pip is hollow and it just says, I just feel so empty inside. And then the therapist is a spoon. This is a very, very difficult image for an image generator to actually produce because it says an illustration of an avocado sitting in a therapist's chair. But the problem is a lot of image generators are going to create an avocado chair instead of an avocado sitting on a chair. So as you can see that's the case right here. Midjourney just produces, you know, a green chair that's avocado colored. It has no context. All the text is wrong. Something like this is pretty cool. Like, don't get me wrong, it looks cool, but it just doesn't meet the prompt at all. The prompt is an illustration of an avocado sitting in a therapist's chair saying, I just feel so empty inside. With a pit-sized hole in its center, the therapist, a spoon, scribbles notes. There's none of that in this image whatsoever. And the difference here is that DALL-E has fully understood the task, and it's also a beautiful, beautiful image. This is the kind of thing that you could see selling on Etsy as a card, as a PNG, whatever it might be. I am so excited to test DALL-E 3 selling Etsy images or whatever. If you're interested in that kind of stuff, please let me know because I will be making more content about Etsy, Shopify, print on demand, etc. if people want me to. Now, about DALL-E 3. DALL-E 3 is now in research preview, so only 400 people currently have access to it. And now, and will be later to ChatGPT Plus and enterprise customers in October via the API and in labs later this fall. I don't even know what labs is. This could be interesting. Labs is like the, okay, that's fine. So modern text image generation systems have a tendency to ignore words or descriptions. This is completely true, forcing users to learn prompt engineering. DALL-E 3 represents a leap forward in our ability to generate images that exactly adhere to the text you provide. Yeah, this is super, super exciting. So another thing that with Midjourney and also the current version of DALL-E is it really doesn't do humans very well. And if you say don't draw humans, it actually does the opposite of that, and it starts to draw loads of humans. So hopefully this will get better as well. Even with the same prompt, DALL-E 3 delivers significant improvements over DALL-E 2. Okay, that's fine. This is the exciting part for me personally. DALL-E 3 is built natively on ChatGPT, which lets you use ChatGPT as a brainstorming partner and refiner of your prompts. Just ask ChatGPT what you want to see in anything from a simple sentence to a detailed paragraph. Now, first of all, what does this mean? It means that we can use ChatGPT to create prompts for DALL-E, which means we can actually create some kind of image generating thing within Python, which will also create prompts from keywords and then create an image. So this is something that I have done before with Stable Diffusion, but it's just going to work a lot better because DALL-E 3 is built natively on ChatGPT. But then even more exciting is the stuff down here. So when prompted with an idea, ChatGPT will automatically generate tailored, detailed prompts for DALL-E 3 that bring your idea to life. If you like the particular image, but it's not quite right, you can ask ChatGPT to make tweaks with just a few words. So I'm not 100% clear whether they're talking about, in this particular sentence, I'm not sure if they're talking about being able to edit the images inside ChatGPT or being able to edit the prompt inside ChatGPT. However, DALL-E 3 will be available to ChatGPT Plus and Enterprise customers in early October. As with DALL-E 2, the images you create with DALL-E 3 are yours to use and you don't need permission to sell them. However, if you actually watch this video here, so it starts off with them asking for a 5-year-old Sorry, just turning off some of the annoying things around here. So they ask for a 5-year-old, an image of what their 5-year-old is imagining right now. So my 5-year-old keeps talking about a super duper sunflower hedgehog. What does it look like? And this is within ChatGPT, remember, this is the beautiful thing. So we're actually going to be able to use DALL-E inside ChatGPT. So now they say, my daughter says its name is Larry. Can I see more like this? And then what does it do? Can you show me Larry's house? It has Larry written on here. This is going to be the absolute future of things like Amazon KDP, but also blog posts. You're going to be able to add your own custom images to your blog posts while you're writing them inside ChatGPT. This is why I'm super, super excited about this. It looks like it might be a ChatGPT plugin. I don't know if it's going to be a plugin or if it's going to be just natively inside ChatGPT. I'm definitely excited to see what comes up, basically. Now, one thing I did notice, so it's not all good news. There are still some problems with DALL-E 3, it seems. Like this picture right here. You can see the prompt is a vintage travel poster for Venus in portrait orientation. This has just given me a really, really, really good idea for a niche on Etsy. The scene portrays the thick, yellowish clouds of Venus with the silhouette of a vintage rocket ship approaching, blah, 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 blah. The problem is, if you actually zoom in here, then you'll see that the text at the bottom isn't quite right. Now, people are probably not going to buy this just purely because, you know, it has some problems still. The text isn't great. This looks like alien text, which is definitely not what we want to be, definitely not what we want to have on something like this. So it's not quite there yet. It's still not 100% perfect. But the fact that it's just such a huge leap between what we have now and, you know, what's next is super, super exciting. And anything that can do text within image generation is going to change the game. So the closest thing we have to this right now is actually with inside Bing Chat, which apparently uses like DALL-E 2.5 or something. And you can see that we do have some results right here, but it's just not quite as good as what we've seen or what we will see for DALL-E 3. However, this might be a good way to produce images now if you didn't know this existed, for example. Bing is super, super interesting. All you have to do is log in and you have 30 conversations with ChatGPT and it can read images, it can read large amounts of text, it can write blog posts, and it can actually create images as well. So for now, at least, while we're waiting for DALL-E 3, we do have this as an option. My plan is to use this probably to sell on Etsy, something like that. Something like vintage travel posters to other planets seems like a really, really nice niche actually. So maybe creating some more of these, but just with all the different planets and just different variations, etc. I think they would sell really, really well. And I'm definitely excited for DALL-E 3. Thank you for watching, and I will see you very, very soon with some more content. Peace out.